Hi guys, I'm going to put two of my Postbag episodes together here. A while back, this arrived in the post, electronic accessories. It's a little kit. Makes flashing LEDs basically, or light chasers. They do sequences. So I bought that because somebody had asked me to do one. And then, watching BigClive.com, he'd reviewed USB soldering irons. And I thought, well, I could try one of those. So I ordered one. And it arrived. So I'll put a link in the video description to the Postbag episode this arrived in. And what I'm going to do is use that to do that. So let's get on with it. Try not to lose any of the bits. That would be a bad start. Right, this contains a CD4017 and an NE555. I don't read Chinese, so I can't tell you what all that says. But the circuit board looks fairly straightforward. We've got a bunch of 1K resistors. And then a couple of other resistors. One will be a 10K and one will be a 2.2K. And the difference between a 1K and a 10K will just be one of the colours on the end. I doubt whether the camera will pick this up, but these are brown, black, black, brown. If we turn that one the other way around, that one is brown, black, black, red. And that third bar is the number of zeros. So brown is a 1, black, black, 0, 0, and then brown after it is one more 0, so that's a 1K. And then brown, black, black, red makes that one a 10K, because red is 2. And then that one I would guess, yes, that looks like that's red, red, black, brown. So that's 220 with one more zero after it. So 2.2K. So we've identified them. The chip should be easy enough to identify because they're different sizes. Capacitor. What else have we got? We've got a couple of capacitors, load of diodes, chip, input connector, and that's about it. So we'll try out the soldering iron. I'll make no attempt to review this because BigClive.com's done that. I'll put a link to his video. Heats up in less than 15 seconds, cool down in less than 30 seconds, long life tip with protective cap. Touch metal point again to restart work. Slightly touching the metal point on the body of the soldering pen and LED will be lightened up and jod can be started. If unused for 25 seconds, the LED light will turn off and pen will go into sleeping mode. A little stand for it. Even got a little bit of solder. That's slightly thinner solder than I normally use, so Well, we'll use the solder they supply. Big Clive said you don't untwist it, you pull it. That's right. Otherwise you're taking the tip off. Put that into there. Run the wire around the back of the camera so it's not in the way. Plug it into my USB supply. Leave it on the paper and that'll probably catch fire to the paper. Okay, so the LED is on, so I assume that means it's probably heating up. Oh yes, smoking a little bit. And it'll probably turn off before we do anything, won't it? Let's start with something easy. That's the little mounting, I don't know what they're called actually. That's the bit the chip goes in, but it saves you heating up the chip directly. So I should be able to solder that. Hold it all still while I'm working on it. Turn my fan on so we can blow away the fumes. Still going. Okay, we've done that. Zoom. Oh, cool down. LED's still on. made a mess of that. It's not fully home. How did that happen? Right, that's better. Expect we can do all those resistors. Right, do I worry about the fact I've put one of them upside down? Some people get upset if they're not all the same way. So we'll do them. Oh, got two more. try and keep out of the way of the camera this time. Okay, let's trim all that lot off. For some reason, my cutters seem to have gone magnetic. Those other two resistors in while I think about them. Red, red, black, 22. Oh, sorry, 2.2. red, black, black. Sorry, black, black, red. Get it the right way round. Variable resistor. Don't seem to want to go in. I like the look of that one. Capacitor, 1 microfarad. 1 microfarad. Right, now all the diodes are LEDs. I think most of you know that the LED's longer leg is the positive. Ones at this end are a bit loose. That's because that capacitor is lifting them up a bit. better. Few of them looked like it wasn't quite hot enough. Well, that's it. That's all of them. Right, we need a 5-volt supply. Let's see what I've got handy. I might just try 3 AAA batteries. they're rechargeable, so that's only going to give us, is that 3.6 volts? We'll see. If it doesn't work, then I'll rig up a USB lead. Let's put our chips in. Looks like it's working with 3.6 volts. Can we trim that? Not with that. How about that? Success. So the USB soldering iron worked. I did feel I may have been underheating it a little bit, but then I've been used to using my big soldering iron that overheats things. But it went together and it works. So have a look in the video description. There'll be links to my two Postbag videos, but I'll put a direct link, the eBay link for this little kit and for the USB soldering iron, and I'll put a link to bigclive.com's review of the soldering iron. Job done.